porque mi vida yo la aprendí en mi vida.
Thank you to all our magnificent callers. See you Monday from 4, Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 7 o'clock. This is Nikki Cardwell. An inquest jury has concluded that errors by West Midlands Police significantly contributed to the death of a woman who was killed alongside her mother by her estranged husband. Janbaz Tarin is already serving at least 32 years in prison for stabbing Ranim Auda and Khawla Salim in Solihull in 2018. West Midlands Police have apologised and say they've already made changes. The Labour MP Jess Phillips says there are similar problems across the UK.
It is simply not prioritised in police forces across our country. It is simply not the case that most women feel that they can rely on police action in these cases. And I'm afraid to say this is just one of the most harrowing examples of that I've ever seen.
A man described as very dangerous by police has admitted murdering a woman he didn't know in East London. Prosecutors said Zara Alina, who was 35, had stood no chance of survival. Jordan Sweeney had only just been released from prison when he targeted her as she walked home in Ilford in June. FIFA says alcohol will no longer be on general sale at the World Cup's 8 stadiums in Qatar, just 2 days before the first match. Organisers had previously promised that alcohol would be available for the tournament. Michael Brunskill from the Football Supporters Association says the U-turn raises wider concerns.
The issue is if they can change their minds on this at a moment's notice with absolutely no explanation, supporters travelling to Qatar will have understandable concerns about whether Qatar can fulfil its other promises relating to things like accommodation, transport, LGBT plus, or other cultural issues.
Eton College says it's disciplined a number of pupils who allegedly used misogynistic and racist language about girls who were visiting from a nearby state school. The elite boys' boarding school, which counts Prince William among its former pupils, has apologised for the incident, which happened during a speech by Nigel Farage. The organisation responsible for global timekeeping has voted to scrap leap seconds. Similar to a leap year, leap seconds have been periodically added to clocks for the past 50 years to make up for the slight difference between the time and the rotation of the Earth. A former head of the group, Felicitas Arias, is happy with the move.
The leap second is introducing a discontinuity on time. Most systems of communication, transport, satellite systems are based on a very, very good time synchronization. And having a 1 second step is really a drawback.
And the weather. There are 7 severe flood warnings in place after heavy rain in Scotland. It should be clearer for the rest of the country. BBC News, it's 3 minutes past 7.
BBC Radio 2! Michelle Visage.
Mama's here. You want to join my fabulous Friday party?
Maybe ABBA could persuade you.
Voulez-vous?
Oh, oui.